Taiwan is known as the Orchid Kingdom, with annual domestic and international sales reaching $7 billion NT dollars. Increasingly, young farmers are dedicating themselves to the industry, aiming to integrate orchids more into everyday life. The cultivation of orchid requires immense patience, along with watering and fertilization within greenhouses. The novelty of orchid wears off quickly for consumers, making the development of new colors, shapes, and sizes crucial. Breeding new varieties is slow, taking at least 3 years for breeding and another 7 for market acceptance. Zhou Boyi, chairman of the Taiwan Orchid Breeders Association, highlights the challenges but remains hopeful for the young farmers, believing in their ability to succeed.
育种200个国家，为什么那么多？因为我要从里面。
I breed around 200 capsules a year. Why so many? It takes work to pick out the good ones. Breeding takes work. We need to improve market acceptability, which is the target production. This is what young farmers will do, and they can make it.
那确实这个是未来年轻人要做，而且年轻人绝对可以做得到。
Expanding the domestic market is a key goal. Su Deng Zhao, an official with the Agriculture and Food Agency, knows that Taiwan's flower market still has room to grow.
国内的这个消费者对于花的这个采购哈，比起日本、欧美。
The consumption of flowers in Taiwan is still far lower than in Europe, the US, and Japan. So we want to cultivate the aesthetics of daily flower use. We are also rooted in the concept of children.
日常用花、生活用花，然后透过这样的一个宣导，我们也扎根在小朋友身上。
Orchid's beauty and Taiwan's soft power are also promoted through various means, such as decorating President Lai Ching-te's inauguration banquet with butterfly orchids. The future of the orchid industry depends on both innovation and expanding domestic consumption. With government support and the creativity of young farmers, Taiwan's Orchid Kingdom is poised to continue growing. 陈新祥、谢宜伦、黄冠伟、郑胜伟 for TVBS World Taiwan.